Jim Alexander here with Real Talker at the premiere of the Creatress. I hope I'm saying it right. Fran Drescher's here. We're talking to her, the director, all the cast of the film. So exciting stuff on the way. Stay tuned for my interviews coming up next.
Here.
Jim Alexander, Real Talker.
Nice to meet you.
Jim.
Oh, Jim.
Jim Alexander, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I always butcher the name, so this is good for once I get a return for it. No, it's all good. I'm speaking with
Jason Cook.
There you go, Jason. Tell me, you've had a long, distinguished career in soap opera. I mean, right? My mom would probably recognize you, I'm sure.
Distinguished is the right word to use, but sure.
But if you're working this industry for a while, you're doing something right, in that sense.
Yeah, I was very fortunate to have a contract role at 19 years old. I was grateful for that, and it enabled me to learn a lot. I learned everything from being on the shows, from the people behind the scenes. So.
And how did that kind of manifest its way or help you to the right point you are right now with, you know, directing a film and kind of setting up your own thing on your way?
The electricians taught me how to wrap cable, and I built it from there.
Yeah. Small stuff. And were you one to observe a lot on set, and in a sense of background kind of work instead of just on camera focus?
I think key to success is in the details. Yeah.
Okay. Lights went off. We're not shutting this down yet. Tell me, what drew you to this story? What kind of inspired you to tell this story, and how did you come? Because it's about the industry in a lot of ways, you know?
The book industry.
True. And,
yeah.
But you have agents here, too, and a writer, too. So it's relatable. I was talking to Lindy, and, you know, the actor's life is relatable in that way. But tell me, what about it that kind of drew you, inspired you to want to come up with the story and tell it?
There's a quote in the book, or in the movie, by Peter Bogdanovich, his character. He plays Theo Mencken, he plays the critic. And he says, books are different than movies, and both are different than real life. So to create a movie that fractures the narrative the way postmodern novels do, and go on that journey with an author as she attempts to pull that off, I thought would be a fun adventure.
Interesting. What did you learn in the development process of it? From the writing part to the directing? Is there and there's a difference too, but what was the thing that you kind of learned that you took away in your career, in a sense, and personally?
Extremely organized.
Something I am not.
We are dealing with three realities in one movie. Mm-hmm. You got to keep that organized, otherwise that can become a jumbled mess. Yeah.
What about the idea of three realities? That seems a lot to juggle for someone putting it together, not only on screen but just in pen to paper. What kind of made you want to do that? Put that aspect of it into the film.
Well, you're watching a movie for 2 hours, so you got to go on that journey, and in 2 hours, like, realizing that you're not watching what you think you're watching, and then realizing that one more time and turning it on its head, you fracture what you perceive as being reality, and I think that could be magical.
Now looking back, now that it's all complete, we're here at the premiere, what's the most satisfactory part for you throughout the whole process? From the beginning to the end, and it says how you can look back at it.
I guess a sigh of relief and just being grateful to all these people. I mean, like, this is not just my circus. This is a lot of people who have supported this. I mean, you know, the fact that Fran was willing to do this movie, wanted to do this movie, and threw herself into this, and Lindy's commitment to the part. I mean, it was not an easy movie to do at all. So, really, like, the actors really pulled us through. Peter was so wonderful. We were gonna try and make it easier for him, and he's like, "Don't make this easier. These are wonderful words. I want to say these words." So, it takes the support from the cast or the crew. I mean, I asked so much of this crew that's here today, and I'm grateful to them. We did 29 locations in 15 days in Los Angeles. We were a traveling circus, and we worked fast. It's
literally.
It's really. It takes a team, and we had a wonderful team.
And finally, when you have actors like Peter and Fran, who are experienced and been through it all, in a sense, in a lot of ways, how much do you let them kind of give them free reign and allow them to do their magic? You know, instead of the creative control that you might have initially going into it.
It's. I mean, I wouldn't even go there. I would actually frame it as you seek their mentorship and advice, because they have a lot of more experience than I do. So they. The fact that I was able to be in an environment where I could learn from them was, I'm grateful for that.
I think it takes a special person to allow, you know, the ego get out of the way and allow the right thing, to, in a sense, a lot of.
This is a team sport, man. Yeah. This is a team sport.
That's the right way about it. I think you're good. You're on your way to directing things. Thank you.